Okay, starting off with the tutorial, I like to put in my contacts first because sometimes my eyes water, and if I already have makeup on, the makeup runs and it's just a big mess that I don't want to deal with. And the first product I'm going to use is Paradise Paint by Mehron in white. And I realized that you couldn't read it, and that's why I was laughing. It was way too close to the camera screen. I'm using a flat top blush brush by Sonia Kashuk, and it's one of my favorite brushes when I'm body painting. It's circular and it's just flat on the top. I'm going to dip it in some water and swirl it around in the white paint until I get the consistency that I want. I want it more watery because I'm just doing a light layer of white for the first layer, and then I'm going to go back and darken it up a bit. So just light for the first time that you're doing it. So right here I am going to go in and just darken up the white on my face just a little bit, just because I want it to be darker than the rest. The next color I'm going to use is dark gray. It's a Mehron color cup. I got these at my local Halloween store. They pretty much have them at any makeup store. And I'm taking a foundation brush, I think it's from Sephora, and I'm just going to dab it and put it on the back of my hand because I don't really want it that dark. I just want it, you know, a little lighter than that. And then I'm just going to start tapping it on my forehead. So that's the area that I want to be that light gray color. Next, I'm taking a blending sponge and I'm just going to start blending those lines out. Using that same color and that same brush, tap lightly under your eye and around your nose and do the same blending with that, and do the same thing on the other side. Next, I'm going to take the Mehron Paradise Paint in white again, and that is a Toni and Guy fluffy blending brush for your eyes, and I'm going to swirl it in the white paint again. And this time I want the consistency to be a little thicker. I'm going to use this and this brush to outline the rib cage. I'm sure this could be more anatomically correct. I apologize for that. Just bear with me. This time I'm taking two different colors. I'm going to take Mehron Paradise Paint in dark blue and that same Toni and Guy brush I was using before. And then I'm also going to take Mehron Paradise Paint in turquoise. Mix them both together with quite a bit of water, and I'm using the cap to one of those paints, and I'm going to mix the two together to create a custom color for this shade. I'm going to take this color and just start blending it down my neck, and I'm going to do that on both sides. I'm also going to use a makeup sponge to help blend those colors down.
In the sky, gazing far into the night, I raise my hand to the fire, but it's no use.
And I did start with that Toni and Guy brush that I was using before, but I did switch to the flat top blush brush because it's much easier when you're working with bigger spaces and you want to go ahead and pull that color down all the way down to your chest. Here I am taking just an angled paintbrush. I got it from my local craft store. I use paintbrushes a lot when I do body paints. And I'm taking my Ben Nye cream paint in black. And I'm going to swirl that brush in there and get the product on it. And I'm going to start lining the rib cage with this. ¶¶ I'm also using this angled brush to blend the inside edges in as I go. Notice how I'm not being a perfectionist right now when it comes to this, because you really don't need to worry about it. It can be messy. Most of it's going to be covered with splatter paint anyways. I'm going back in with the flat top brush and the Mehron Paradise paints in turquoise and dark blue, and I'm just going in and alternating between the colors and darkening up the area from the neck down to the chest. Here I'm just taking a big fluffy powder brush and I'm going in and blending out those areas. Here I'm taking that literally same brush. You would think I don't own that many brushes. I do, but that one's just my favorite. And I'm getting it extremely wet, and I'm gonna just lightly push on my neck and the color will drip down. Next, I'm taking the dark blue Mehron Paradise paint and a crease brush from EcoTools, mixing it with the water and the paint, and flicking it on my skin to get texture. But it's no use, 'cause you can't stop it from shining through. It's true, baby, let the light shine through if you believe. Next thing I'm going to do is take a detailing paintbrush and the Mehron White Paradise paint, and I'm going to use it to start painting on the teeth for my demon. Here I'm taking that same detail brush and the black Mehron Paradise paint in the palette, and I'm just going in between and filling in all the teeth. I would fill in the rest, but my camera died right about here, so I only fill in half, but you are going to want to fill in all of it. Here I'm taking the black out of the Mehron Paradise paint palette, and I'm going to use it to start doing some veins. Here I am fixing up my paint splatter because I realized that I totally screwed it up by painting the veins over the teal. Here I'm taking the same brush and the same color to add detailing into the ribcage. Once again, same detailing brush as before. This is the Mehron Pastel Paradise paint palette, and I'm just going to go through and do some light blue veins on my face leading up to my eyes. I'm taking the blue out of the Mehron Basic palette, the Royal Blue, and I'm just going in and darkening up those veins, and I'm also going to add some more underneath my chin and my face. I'm also going to use the same color to fill in the shape for my nose. In this next step, I'm using Pros-Aide to apply the horns. I made the horns out of Ben Nye Scar Wax and coated them in Ben Nye Liquid Latex, and now I'm applying them with the Pros-Aide. Just put a light layer of Pros-Aide on your face and a little bit on the actual appliance, and then just stick them on your skin and blend them. Just a side note, this stuff is super waterproof. You're gonna need a special Pros-Aide remover to get it off. After putting those on, I'm going back in with the EcoTools brush and the turquoise Mehron Paradise paint, and I'm going to paint the horns, and then I'm going to go back in and detail with a little bit of the dark blue Mehron paint. Here I'm taking the Lorac Pro palette, and I'm using the black, and I'm going to do the shapes of my eyes, and blend out that black. And I'm going to do a really large shape from like the corner of my eye all the way to my temple. Here I'm taking that same angled paintbrush from before and painting the Mehron white under my eyes to make my eyes look bigger. Here I'm taking e.l.f. liquid liner and I'm going to use it to line that area that I just used the white in. And I would show you the full thing, but once again my camera died. Oh look, just kidding. My camera just paused apparently. Here I'm going to come in with my Sephora color anthology palette. I think it's got like 50 colors in it. I'm going to use the dark blues to blend around the horns and give it some depth. And then I'm going to also come in with my Urban Decay electric palette and use the lighter bright blue color to blend around the horns and also from the inside corner of my eyes out. Using that same color blue, I'm going to give my nose a highlight and blend around my jaw as well as my cheekbones with that darker blue. Once again, coming in with the white Mehron Paradise paint and a fluffy powder brush, and I'm just dabbing the white down to give the blue on my chest and my neck some texture. And now I'm using the dark blue to go on top of that just to blend it in. I'm coming in with the e.l.f. liquid liner to detail a little bit of veins around the horns. Here I'm taking the Mehron Basic Palette in the Royal Blue and I'm using a tissue because I don't want that blue to drip onto the white teeth of my mouth. And I'm just going to do like I did with my neck and just lightly touch and let those colors drip down. You can also do a little freestyle painting to get the desired drip look that you want. I did that on the other eye because I wanted it to look different. Next up, I'm just putting on eyelashes. I got these at my local Halloween store. They're just some blue false lashes. And then I'm going to come in with the Ben Nye Pressed Color Palette shadows in black to fix my shadow because it was creasing. Thank you so much for watching. I had so much fun with this tutorial. I'm going to put all of the music used in this video with links in the description box. Be sure to check out all of those really great artists. If you have any questions, comments, or concerns, make sure you drop those down below. And if you like what you saw, don't forget to like and subscribe.